Hello and welcome to today's video. We are here the other side of Hospice Street near Welshpool at Breidden Hill, climbing to what's known as Rodney's Pillar. And we're taking this path, which seems to be a fairly steady incline with lots of woodland. Should be a good couple of mile walk, about an hour and a half, maybe 2 hours, but should be fun. I'm here with my good friend John.
Hello.
There he is. Say hello, John.
Hello, John.
So without further ado, let's climb the hill. So I haven't been walking for too long, probably about 5 minutes, and looking at the path, it just seems like a constant uphill, which you'd expect on a hill, of pretty much a flat, easy, what do you call this, John?
Incline.
Well, it's like gravel, isn't it? Compacted,
yeah,
gravel.
Hardcore.
Like hardcore. So it's not, not overly hard for those that fancy an hour or so up the hill, but we'll see what we get when we get a little bit further in. Now, I don't know this hill, didn't even know it existed until John said about it, but I'm glad he did, because looking up around here, wow, all them woodlands. All that wood. And it goes up there. I think might be a little downhill stream here. Ah. Oh yeah, there is. So, I don't know if it's drinkable water. Certainly something I wouldn't advise, but this seems to be a little secretly hidden, although it's hard to hide a hill, area, little pocket of countryside on the Welsh-English border. We're in Wales now, aren't we, John?
Yeah.
Yeah. So we're only just in Wales, but can't see much here, but look at the view if you can see it. And from what I gather from pictures, it's like that up at the top. But we're going to take this path. This is a logging path, I think, or a quarry path, and we're going to see where it ends up. So I'll see you in a little minute.
Well,
walked a little bit of way up. I'd say we're about 30 minutes in, and I can't show you now because we're around the corner, but the hill, when it's close up, is quite an incline, and I think this is probably the easiest way up. The incline is steady, gradual, and actually quite enjoyable. I'm a little bit out of breath, but nothing like I was on the Kirkcaldy. Now, John informed me, he read the thing, information at the bottom of the hill, that this is closed on a Tuesday and a Saturday due to pheasant shooting. So Probably best not to come on those days, but if you do, don't dress up as a pheasant. That's my advice for the day. But carrying on, looks like a little logging place, this little logging road. Easy gradual incline to the summit. with a bit of luck. Should be there in about an hour, you say, John?
Probably, yes, man.
Right, anyway.
Tea and scones.
Tea and scones at the top of the hill. I forgot the stones, but I got the tea.
Oh, cool.
What a fail. Some more hills around here, John, we could be climbing. Yeah. Up there. Yeah. Yep. Well, I can always check it out on the ordnance surveys. See what we got up there. So we're going to continue walking. Hopefully we'll get to Rodney's pillar in about an hour, hour and a half at most. But so far a good walk. So I think we're about mile and a half, 2 miles in. So far fairly simple, not too strenuous. However, much of the walk, there's not really much to see. I mean, if you're into looking at trees and grass, that's fine. And don't get me wrong, I love looking at trees too. It's actually quite nice looking in between these trees and seeing what wildlife we might be able to see. I can't say I've seen any yet, apart from that big bear there. But, you know, just for a general hike out, it's quite nice. But a bit of a drizzle. Nothing too serious, and the coat's holding up well. This is a new jacket I bought, really water resistant, and the new bag that I've got is holding up well as well. And I've got some new toys in the bag, which I might show you in a bit. I'm not sure if I'm allowed to, but I'll tell you who they're from, and maybe in the future it was something that you can buy. But we'll see what we get. So off this little path, heading this way, and looks like a little boardwalk that way. Just a bit of advice on this hill. Breidden Hill seems to be a private owned hill, and the owners here, this is the only permissible path so far, and the owners do ask that if you do bring a dog, just keep in mind that it has to be kept on lead. I think that's out of the respect of the wildlife, but also to respect the estate. Keep your dogs on the lead. There's also no bikes and no horses here, so nothing really to... you see it, do you, John?
Yeah.
Oh, we're just coming up to our first sighting of Rodney's pillar. Now, I didn't think it was as close as it is, but we do have a bit of a trek. I'll see if we can show you in a second. Oh, there it is, in the mist. Let's see if we can zoom you in. And there she is. Oh, hey. I don't know, do pillars have a male or female thing?
Admiral,
there you go, Rodney's pillar, all the way up there. You don't really get the perspective of distance, but I'm guessing we're walking down that little incline to the right.
Incline.
And then somewhere at the back of that hill, and it'll be a scramble up to the pillar. Should be good. So we'll carry on walking, we'll see where we go and see what we can see. So, sorry John. So we've had to come a little bit up a grass track, no longer the gravel hardcore. And and we've just discovered the path. It's given us a bit of a surprise. It's given us an easy up, and then it's given us this very last, looks to be the last push up the hill through these trees up to Rodney's pillar. So you can follow those little markers and that'll take you up there, no problem at all, and you're not going to get into any trouble for not being on the path. So there's John having a walk uphill. He seems to be taking it steady, and that's exactly what I'm going to do, and I'm looking forward to a nice cup of tea in my new flask. Hopefully my coffee's, hopefully my drink's going to be nice and warm for when I get up there. The wind's picked up a bit, the weather's closing in, but all in all, it's a good walk, glad I came. So next time you'll see me, I'll be up that top at Rodney's pillar. Well, we made it. I'm shouting because it's bloody windy up here. I'm hoping it's going to come through on the camera again. Got a bit of a muff on there, so I'm hoping it'll sort the wind out. Let's see if I can get there we go. We're out of the wind. But this is Rodney's pillar. There's a bit of an information plaque. With it being repaired, but it's not legible. But wow, what a view! And I tell you what, well worth coming up here. I didn't know about this hill initially. Well, there's no wind here, but I'm glad I came. Just have a gander of all this out here. Ain't that amazing stuff? See if I can get out of this wind, have a cup of tea. John's having a cup of soup. How did you find the walk then, John?
Alright, mate.
Is it worth coming up?
Yeah.
That's good practice for snow, though, isn't it? I'll leave you to eat your dinner. Right, I'm going to have a coffee and then we'll make the descent back down the way we came. Down this little path here, all the way down there, and then follow the woodland path back that way. There is a few ways you can go. You can go this way, down there, but apparently that's really steep, and after the rain that we've had recently, it's probably not advisable. But done it, we're here, we're happy. Well, that was Rodney's pillar, and we're just now making the descent down a different way that we came up. This is a little bit of an easier way, so there is a choice of following the bridle path up to the top of the hill. But down. There we go. But I will say this path does take you along the edge of the quarry here. So in essence of safety, keep to the paths as best as you can. In fact, it's not that hard to not keep to the path. Otherwise you might find yourselves in a bit of trouble, and nobody wants to have that trouble at all. But all in all, it's been a good walk. It's about 2.5 miles from the car park to the top, and I'm anticipating obviously the same amount on the way home. But perhaps a bit slippy. John's demonstrating. He's doing a good job there, demonstrating a slippy path. Well, As a meat. So maybe a good pair of footwear, some good walking poles. I haven't bought my poles today, I should have done, but to be fair, it's not that bad. So we're just gonna make our way down, see where we're going, make our way down and choose where we're going next. Actually, this is definitely a bridle path. This is supposed to be the easy way. Well, it's far better coming down here than it would be the way we came up.
I don't know.
Oh, I do.
Now, if you're a tree lover like me, this is a good place to come. Some amazing trees. Some of them, I would say, a couple of hundred years old, if not longer. Obviously, this time of year, no leaves, so it's just silhouettes. And they make amazing, amazing little artwork for the side of the hills. So there we go. Right, I'm going to get on with this path before I slip over and make a complete fool of myself. And we'll see you a little bit down the trail.
So it turns out we've just been walking down this path and we've been followed by a pheasant. We've no idea how long it's been, but John is trying to have a conversation with it. Let's see how lucky he gets. Seems like the pheasants are friendly because he's been following us. He doesn't seem to be interested now to talk to us. You can't give a pheasant biscuits.
So yeah, the walk back is fairly simple, straightforward, quite easy. The sun's come out, the blue skies. I wish we were at the top of the hill now, because the weather is so much nicer than it was when we first started out. But for a place that I didn't know existed, I feel ashamed because I grew up in Shropshire, but this is literally on the English-Welsh border at the edge of Shropshire and Powys.
He's just been running at you. We're being attacked by a pheasant now. So
yeah, nice pheasant.
So yeah, I mean we
he
is, isn't he?
Oh dear, John's being chased by a pheasant down the path. That was funny. Yeah, for a place I didn't really know existed, I think this is a really good walk. Glad I came. Looks like
he's climbing the hill.
Ambush!
He's going to come round the front of us, right? He's got his mates down the further on down the path, right?
Ambush position, that is.
And he wants our soup.
So yeah, if you really, I've got to come back. Discovered there's some geocaches up here, so I'm going to come back sometime in the future and see if we can grab them. And we're still being followed by that pheasant, so I guess the locals are quite friendly too. So maybe he'll be around when we come back to geocache as well. But all in all, wonderful walk. Recommend anybody coming out to this.
No. Well, we've made it. So back to the car. We've been to the top of Breidden Hill, to the Rodney's Pillar. We came down a different way, as you saw. I mean, we came down the quarry path. I think it's a bridle way.
and not the actual footpath. But it was a lot, the steep incline, it wasn't a steep incline at all, it was a lot easier underfoot. All in all, I think it's took us about a couple of hours.
Yeah.
I did have the app open. It was that one. Yeah, 2 hours, 38 minutes in total from top to bottom and back again.
We had about 20 minutes up there, didn't we?
We had a couple of minutes up there, yeah, about 20 or so. But that was on pause. He had his soup. So 5.1 miles in total. So it wasn't too bad of a trek, to be honest. My opinion of the hill, as I say, I've never been here before. I didn't even know it existed. It's certainly one that I'm going to come back again with the family, do some geocaching, just make your way over to Breidden Hill, get yourself out here, climb that hill, bag Rodney's pillar, and the views up there are amazing. John, thanks for suggesting this place and asking me to come out. Like, but any final thoughts from you?
Yeah, just come and do it. Get yourself out there and do it.
Is this place you've walked before, or is this something?
No, some of the lads at work told me about it.
Somebody told you about it.
Mm-hmm.
Well, there you go. Somebody told him, and we've now told you. So come out to Breidden Hill. It's near. It's on the Welsh Pool Road. Just coming outside of Shrewsbury.
Just Google it.
Or Google it.
It's a lot easier.
Can't really give you the spelling because I ain't got a clue, but. Google it and you'll find it.
Boom. So
we're gonna head off, get ourselves some warm coffee when we get home, and
a burger.
Thanks for watching. If you like the video, click the like. If you're new to the channel, click the subscribe button. Future walks, we've got one coming next week. It'll either be me on my own or John will be with me as well. So yeah, we'll see you all in the next video.